I'm very proud today to be joined by Colonel Bill Larkin, also a senator, as we welcome the cadets of West Point, who really are the future leaders of our country, who in light of what's going on in the world are serving. That we have this great institution in New York gives me great pride, and I'm thankful to Colonel Larkin, who sponsors this every year in the state senate.
Well, Joe, it's nice for me, and I appreciate the accolades, but you know, without the cooperation of my colleagues, yourself, this is the first year in a long time where you haven't had a cadet. You know, when these cadets see their representatives and they can remember them back home, earlier today, you were talking with a cadet who knew somebody from right. your area, but he's a firstie and he's taken a final. These are the finest, the breath of fresh air for America. If you realize that 18 to 19,000 people make an application to West Point, they accept 1,000. And in the next 4 years, it isn't, you know, well, let's go out Friday night. The cadet said to you this morning, Friday night is not an easy night, especially for a freshman. Joe, I remember you asked him how many days off he gets. He said, how many minutes is a lot easier.
Right. And I would just point out, too, you pointed out on your floor comments, honoring the West Point veterans. Those graduates from right here, West Point, New York, next year who are graduating will probably be in combat somewhere in the world leading troops. So we owe them a great deal of thanks, and we owe you a great deal of thanks as well, Colonel.
But I couldn't not accomplish this without the leadership of Dean Skelos and all of our colleagues. When you come to West Point Day, there is no Democrat, Republican, or Independent. It's state senators in support and appreciation for what West Point stands for.